What's up, Knights? On today's show, we learn more about the popular martial art of jiu-jitsu, meet the Higley High School kitchen staff, and check out a small business that is running a promotion you'll want to stay tuned for. Don't go anywhere because an all-new episode of The Studio starts right now.
Hey, can you put this away?
Sure.
And every time it rains, and it's from heaven.
Shoo-be-doo-be.
Don't you know each cloud contains banners from heaven?
Shoo-be-doo-be.
Caden, everyone.
Hey Knights, I'm Kane Peterson. While many students here at Higley participate in traditional American sports, some have found their passion in the martial arts. Mikey and Eric caught up with two Knights to find out what jiu-jitsu does for them.
Nice!
Jiu-jitsu was a self-defense sport that originates from Japan and eventually made its way into America. Although it's not nearly as popular as traditional sports, a few of our own Higley Knights explained to us why they're so passionate about it.
I want to pursue a amateur career in MMA, and jiu-jitsu is a good tool to have when you're in the octagon because some people just like to grab you and wrestle you, and jiu-jitsu is a good way to, you know, be safe on there, just know what you're doing when it happens. Back in the day when MMA was still a fresh thing, like not as mainstream as it is today, most people thought boxers were like the most dominant sport or dominant martial art. It's different because being small is actually advantageous to the bigger person because you can get in position more easier because the bigger guy can't pass guard as easily as a smaller dude. It's a full contact thing because when you're rolling with someone, you can actually go at it and try to actually choke them out. It's been very, very exciting and very enlightening to martial arts because there's so much discipline and so much knowledge people have about jiu-jitsu and so much stuff you can learn from it.
You should do jiu-jitsu because it's really fun. And you get to meet a lot of different people, and the experiences you have with it are really great. The gym I go to is called Faction Combatives. It's really good if you wanna hop in there and start training, you get a free week. I recommend everyone should go and try jiu-jitsu because it really helps you grow as a person.
If you're looking to expand your interests and try something new, be sure to check out some local jiu-jitsu classes. This is Mikey and Eric reporting for The Studio.
What's up, Knights? I'm Sophia Riggs. Recently, Drama performed their end-of-the-quarter performance Trap, a mystery-style story where all but one person in high school falls unconscious. The theater brought the story to life and found out the secret. Great job, Knights!
This week was Spirit Week in the Kingdom. Monday was Taurus Day, Tuesday was Rival Day, Wednesday was Prep Day, Thursday was Throwback Thursday, and today is Color Block. Can't wait to see you all in your class colors!
Robotics Club is an extracurricular activity preparing students for a wide variety of occupations and applications for one's future. Vanessa and Christelle met with their robotics coach and a few members of the club to learn more.
Engineering teacher Mr. Sixkiller and several members of the robotics club met with us to share their experiences in the club, including their previous competition that was hosted in Higley's gym.
First, you need your robot. So Jake usually constructs the robot, Eric usually builds the code, and I usually work on the notebook.
As a club, and as members have continued to come year after year, they have built a bond special to them that they take time to share about.
One of my favorite aspects of the club is basically the communication aspect. We are very much a family in this club.
I love just personalities of everyone. We get along really good. Last year, we'd bring balloon animals on the bus, and we'd make them, and it's just a fun experience.
One of my favorite memories is definitely going to our competitions and just having a few laughs.
Just those times where we can all be ourselves, we can relax. I think those are the times that I really enjoy the most.
While those involved continue to grow as a program, they each have their own roles as a part of it and also use robotics as an attribution to their personal growth and future career paths.
I'm in this club because I want to pursue a future in engineering, and I just feel like this is a good stepping stone to that future.
This is a very good application for engineering fields especially robotics fields. And it also serves as a way for me to strengthen my communication skills and have companionship along the way.
I would say it's a fun environment. You get to make lots of friends, and you get to do, if you really like engineering, you get to do something fun with it, and you can apply those skills.
There's a role for everybody in robotics. You can be a master builder. You can learn to build. You can be a programmer. You can document the projects. You need people to come in, and just all backgrounds are needed. Strengths and weaknesses are all needed. So
yeah, join robotics.
This has been Christelle and Vanessa. Peace out.
When it comes to our school lunches, most of us have never stopped to consider the work that goes into its daily preparation. Hayden and Sean set out to highlight the efforts of men and women who work tirelessly behind the scenes to ensure we never go hungry.
The lunch staff here at Higley High is a vital part of our school. As an overutilized and under-recognized group, Sean and I decided to put a spotlight on them to get a behind-the-scenes look into the kitchen.
We're blessed with some wonderful lunch. Actually, we have some gentlemen back there as well. They're awesome. They work really hard, and honestly, most of the students are terrific. But sometimes I feel we can treat them significantly better. Just be respectful of one another. If somebody is struggling, help them out. On Fridays, they also hand some bags and some take-home stuff for those who want it. I love it because it really warms my heart when I see other people saying, hey, I'll get that for you, let me help you. The more we can do that, the better, the more we're a family. I'm weird, but I've always worked in schools. I loved school when I went to school, and maybe this makes me strange, but I actually like school lunches. So I liked it. This is one of the better ones I've had.
I have a favorite lunch item. Well, tater tots are, you know, always good. I don't know who doesn't like tater tots, but tater tots, the pizza's generally pretty good. I like to get a salad. The nachos are always good. Stir Fry Station is awesome when we do it.
With all their hard work they do for us, being respected by the student body is a very important part of the kitchen staff's day.
I don't know that they always voice it, but you know, if I'm standing at the door counting, like I am today, they're usually very appreciative and say thank you and have a nice day. So I'm pleasantly surprised most of the time.
Next time you get a hot meal after a long day in math, remember to thank one of the lunch staff for all their hard work they do for us. This has been Hayden and Sean signing out for The Studio.
U.S. history students are learning about Prohibition. In the 1920s, underground illicit nightclubs, known as speakeasies, gained popularity. On Tuesday, the history buildings got together and created their own versions of these secret establishments.
On this week's teacher feature, we check in with math teacher Mr. Hong. Having grown up in South Korea, Mr. Hong's life experiences have likely been quite different than yours and mine. Connor and I talked with him about his childhood and why he moved to the United States.
Mr. Hong is a math teacher here on campus that was born and raised in South Korea. Kaden and I wanted to know a bit about what it was like living there.
I'm from South Korea. I used to live in Siheung, which is southbound of Seoul. Seoul is capital of South Korea. Huge difference was here, when we pass between strangers, we sometimes smile, sometimes we just nod, sometimes we even say hello just to be friendly. We never do that in South Korea. So it was kind of strange for me to like adjust setting. When I passed certain people, they were just smiling at me, they were just nodding, and I was like, I didn't quite understand what's going on, but now I know.
Mr. Hong talked a bit about the process of him moving here to the U.S.
I did not want to move to U.S. at all. I had to serve in military for 2 years. After I got released from military, I was ready to go job market. Had an English as a second language program in Sonoma State University in California, which is close to Napa Valley. So I went there just to learn English for 1 year, and I was supposed to come back to Korea after 1 year. I even had a flying ticket booked. And I loved life in US. The biggest part was the style of life here is more like you can actually have life in US. Called my mom, said, Mom, I'm not coming back. And she was like, what do you mean you're not coming back? I love US. I'm gonna go to the college here. I'm gonna do some education. I ended up just staying here. And I love my life here. So I love my decision at the time. And yeah, So life in US, I'm very satisfied.
The students here are glad to have him and look forward to having him here for years to come. This is Caden and Connor reporting for The Studio. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. He always been faking me out. Can't make you happier now. Sometimes all I think about is you. Late nights in the middle of June. He always been faking me out. Can't make you happier now.
The marketplace has a variety of snacks and drinks specifically selected for our student body. We highly recommend visiting during your lunch. However, students are no longer permitted to visit during class. The baristas will be denying requests during that time.
Academic Decathlon is looking for new team members next year. The topic will be water, the most essential resource. Topics will include marine biology, art and music, inspired and created by water, the impact of water on history and society, and so much more. If you're interested, visit Ms. Matthew in room 233 for more information.
Sophia Hendrickson is a teenage entrepreneur who created her own jewelry business. We talked to her about what makes her small business, Gem Z, so unique.
Sophia Hendrickson is a hardworking high school student who decided to put her creativity to the test and create her own jewelry business.
One day, I was just extremely bored, sitting on my couch, chilling with the dog, you know, and I was like, I'm about to make jewelry. So I went to the garage, I found some wire, some pliers, and I just wrapped it around my finger. It didn't really work, so I decided, hey, I'm gonna go invest in all of this stuff, and whatever happens, happens.
So I was just on Instagram, and I saw someone promoting a jewelry business, so I checked it out, figured out it was Sophia, and all this stuff is really cute, and the prices are really good, not to mention.
I've made over $300 so far. It's been a super successful business for me. I wanted a name that communicated how inclusive my business was. Our generation is probably one of the most accepting generations there is, so why not put a twist on that? So I decided to go with Gem Z Jewelry. Everything is customizable. I have a bunch of different types of crystals and gems, different types of wires, and I'm going to be adding to that in the weeks to come.
So on her site, there's a lot of different color options you could choose from. I went with the silver with the emerald gem, and it's so pretty. With everything I wear, but depending on your style, you could choose whatever color combination you want.
Having good communication with your customers is vital to running a good business, and Sophia does just that.
So when it comes to shipping, I do ship worldwide. I've shipped to the UK, I've shipped all over the US.
The shipping was super fast, and she communicated really well throughout the whole process, so I knew what I was getting into.
Make sure you guys check out my Etsy. It's gonna be Gem Z Jewelry. And if you mention that you're from Higley, I'll throw in extra earrings. Or if you mention your ring size, I can throw an extra ring for you too.
If you're looking for some cute rings and necklaces for a great price, make sure to check out Gem Z Jewelry on Etsy and support small businesses. This is Kaylee and Sophia signing off for The Studio.
That's all we got for you this week, Knights. Have an amazing spring break and a happy St. Patrick's Day. Don't drink too many Shamrock Shakes.
When I look at you in your eyes.